or the respect for human rights and U.S. policy and U.S. diplomacy, that made me wonder, because the U.S. pronouncements are all about democracy and respect for human rights and protecting the rights of others and that sort of thing. And yet we have a key policymaker who always seems to show up no matter what the administration is. And in his early formative foreign policy making years, when he actually had a position in the U.S. government, was saying quite the opposite. So I went to Congress with sort of open eyes and an open mind. I was offered the opportunity to stay in Congress forever, for the rest of my life. But I had to do certain things in order to enjoy that. And the reason I'm not in the U.S. is because I refused to do those things, which basically meant that I would have to lie to my listeners and lie to the people. I had built up a pretty good, reputation for integrity. And so what I found was that these particular individuals wanted me to lease my integrity reputation to them so that they could then in turn use it for something for their benefit, which was not necessarily the benefit of the people of the United States. That's when I began to understand the game. And what I really was when the Democrat chairman of my subcommittee was going after in an extremely oppositional manner, a witness who had been invited to testify before our international relations subcommittee. And so I thought, no, because at this time I'm still drinking Kool-Aid, I'm still, you know, a real Democrat, and not really understanding what that means. Yeah. And way to go, get in. And then after the subcommittee hearing, they walk out arm in arm, embracing each other. And I said it was all for show. It was just for the C-SPAN cameras. That was it. And so then I began to understand, okay, this is a game. My dad had always told me that politics is a game, right? Mm-hmm. That was my in-house confirmation that politics is a game. And then I started getting these phone calls asking me, when are you going to do this? And when are you going to do that? And when are you going to do that? And then I got the offer. And the offer was, we can put you on the cover of Newsweek, Times, you can stay in Congress for the rest of your life, you just have to do this one thing. Well, this was before Sudan had been balkanized into two countries. And this was the objective of this group of people who had approached me because of my integrity. And so they wanted me to get arrested in front of the Sudan embassy and then to promote this lie about Sudan, and I refused to do it. There were many of my colleagues who did, but the campaign didn't have the same effect because they were going to get very high